channel. I've got a ton of requests to do a smoky eye tutorial, so that's what we're gonna do today. And I'm going to use the Magnificent Metals, the new Stila products. Very easy, very fun. So if you are interested, go ahead and keep watching.
Okay guys, first we are going to take the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. This is a regular for me, I love it so much. I'm going to take the double-sided Naked 3 brush. Again, I got this in my Naked 3 palette. I take the flat side and I just apply it all to my bottom lid with the most product, and then I brush it upwards just to distribute it evenly, and then I take the other side and blend it out. Okay, next we are going to take, again, my all-time favorite blending brush. It is the E40 Sigma brush. I'm going to take this transition shade. It is like a lighter kind of peachy color. And we are going to apply this a little above my natural crease, just so that we can bring up any other brown color for our smoky eye. Okay. Next, we are going to go in with this orange and milk chocolate kind of color, and we are going to take this and put this in our crease using the same E40 Sigma blending brush. I want this to be our bolder transition color. It's always nice to have a brown on top of the black. The brown actually just looks better with the smoky eye. So I think that everyone will agree with me when they say that brown is the one transition color when doing a smoky eye. So again, we're just gonna keep blending. I do add a little bit more orange because, like I said, I want this to be bold, but make sure that you blend. We may have to go back in and use the lighter transition color that we first used and make sure that it is blending well. Blending is the key. Okay, next is where we are going to start applying our black shadow. I'm just going to take this flat lid definer brush. I'm not exactly sure the number, but I will list it in the description down below. We are still using the 35W palette, and I don't believe that I displayed that earlier. But I'm just going to be taking a black shadow. Obviously any black shadow works, and I highly recommend the Urban Decay's black shadow, but any black shadow will work. I do use the same technique that I did when putting on my primer. I apply it on the bottom first and then I bring it upward. I don't want it to be too harsh, but I do also want to remember that I will be able to blend it. So if you make it a little harsh in your crease or bring it up too high, that's fine. We will be blending later. I don't know why I'm so excited, but I'm going to be using some tape. What we are trying to achieve is a sharp wing. And instead of using an actual eyeliner, I'm just going to bring down the eyeshadow from the black that we're already using. So make sure that you are forming it in a triangle shape and then bring it up to your lid just to blend it in and make it look like it's natural wing. We want to make it as sharp as possible. Now we are going to blend, as I said before, and I will say again, blending is the key, 100%. We will blend a little, add a little. So if you feel that you haven't added enough black or you haven't blended enough, now is the time. So here what I'm doing is actually keeping my eye open and then putting in the black in my crease, but I'm doing it ever so lightly so that when we blend, it will still transition well. I'm gonna actually skip ahead a little bit because this is just going back in, blending, adding, blending, adding. So take this time to add as much black as you need for your eye shape and make sure to blend in with your transition colors. Okay, now that we are finished blending, we are going to take the new Stila Magnificent Metals. I sure hope that I'm saying that right. I obviously had it upside down. This is so much fun. It is so easy to apply. It stays on so well. The one thing is that you have to let it dry for a little while before you completely like start blinking around everywhere, or else it will transfer from your actual lid to your upper lid into your crease. Now, once you let it dry, it is fine. I had no fallout. It's great. I honestly love this product so much. I'm ordering the rest of the colors. Yes. So I'm going to take this all over my lid. I am actually going to apply it across the wing just to give the wing obviously more sparkle along with the lid. And if you have not already noticed, I obsess over this. I probably apply 4 or 5 coats just because I want my lids to be seen from the gods up above. Like, love this so much. My dance, that's so funny. So obviously give it some time to dry, and we will be back. Okay, my lids should be dry. I am going to curl my lashes now. I had a curling or a lash curler in my last video that I bragged about a little, but I actually did not like it. So back to my old one, no spring. We are going to go in with the Colossal Big Shot Mascara. I have been using this daily, even without lashes, and I love it. It really does what it says, and it keeps my lashes straight up all day. No other application needed. I know that I'm bragging really hard on it, but my lashes do tend to fall, I would say even 4 or 5 hours after putting mascara on, and this mascara does such a great job at keeping them straight up. Okay, now on to more blending. That is my Luxie 231 brush, which I absolutely adore. We're going to go in with the Black Shimmer, and this is still the 35W palette. I do want to make sure that we don't have any harshness with the liquid glitter. We do still need to blend that out, bring any glitter up on the crease, just so we have a perfect amount of glitter evenly spread across the lid and the crease. Okay, because I did have some glitter fallout, I wanted to take that off. I'm going to take this Sephora brush. Again, I'll put the details down below in the description box. And I'm going to just brush that glitter away before I put on my concealer. Then I will put concealer, and then I will put some setting powder on, and we are almost done with our look. We will go ahead and add the lashes. These are Featherette from House of Lashes. I love these, and I usually only wear these whenever I am doing a really bold look. These have been my favorite for so long now, but I do love House of Lashes regardless. I will apply the lashes and be right back. Now we are going to highlight the brow bone. We are going to take this bone color, and I'm not sure the brush, put it in the description below. We're going to use the 350 Morphe palette, and we are just going to highlight this brow bone real quick. This is also a good time to blend the transition color into the brow bone. So adding a little bit above any harsh lines, this would be a great color and a great time to do so. On to concealer. This is my favorite concealer. It is by It Cosmetics, Bye Bye Under Eye, in the medium shade. I love this. I have small wrinkles, and I do have slight dark under eyes. This, I mean, takes away any secrets that I have hidden under my bags, and no one knows about them until about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, because I've been wearing them all day. I'm using this MAC brush to blend it out. I do like this brush. I feel like it is great for this product. I believe that it could be more of a foundation brush, but I just use it for my concealer in this case. We will go ahead and bake as well. I'm going to use some of the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. I love this thing so much. I actually have been told to get a different setting powder so that I don't waste the obviously nicer, more expensive setting powder, but I can't help it. It does miracles for me. And again, with the hiding the secrets, this helps just as much. I love it so much. Okay, after letting that sit for a little bit, we will go ahead and dust off any loose powder that we have left under the eye. I usually let mine sit for about 5 minutes or so, maybe less. Usually in the time I will contour while waiting for it to bake. So now we will use this Sephora flat brush for our under eye. We will use the same black that we used for the 35W palette, and we will ever so lightly brush it against our bottom lid, almost against our lash line. We don't want to make it so harsh, and we also want to make sure that we are blending in the process as well. We will be adding in the brown and the orange color that we used on our lid as well, so don't apply too much. Going back in with the Luxie 231 brush, and we're going to take the milk chocolate color first, and we will apply product on that brush and then brush it against the black shadow that we just applied. So you're blending in the process, but then we are also putting a transition color so that it doesn't look too harsh. I know I keep using the word harsh, but I'm very strict on any dark lines or you walking around with no eyelids blended. I don't want that for you, honey. Now we are taking a smaller brush. I'm going to be using a more sparkly, glittery color for the inner eye corner. I use this color every time that I am putting product in my inner eye, and it comes across so pretty, so beautiful. Next, I will use the Sephora Black Pencil eyeliner, and I will apply that on the waterline of my lid, of my eyeball. And I try to apply as much as I can. It does not make it super dark, but we will be putting a black shadow on top of it just to set it, and this makes it so dark. So using the flat brush from Sigma, I will be taking some of the black shadow that we've been using and just put that on top of the liner. Again, this helps also if you are wearing black liner often. This won't have the liner run. You know how you hate to reapply your liner? If you set it, it won't run. It won't run away. Just set it down. Okay, just kidding, sorry. Okay, now we need to apply some mascara to the bottom lash line. I do add a few coats to this. I want to make my bottom lashes very long, very noticeable. So probably 12 to 15 coats at max. Just kidding. And now we have finally made it to the finish line. I'm using the Too Faced Candlelight Highlighter. I love this highlighter. I've been using it for so long, but I switched over to Becca. Still such a pretty highlighter. I'm going to use the lighter side, the more white side, and I'm going to apply that right on the top of my cheekbone, across my, on the side of my temple, and then a little above my eyebrow as well. I apply it to the tip of my nose and as well on my Cupid's bow. And once finished, you are done.
Okay guys, that is it for today's look. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought. Give me any feedback that you guys have. Also give me any feedback for the voiceover. That's something different for me. So I'm gonna try that out and see if I can make my videos a little shorter. Give me any suggestions that you guys wanna see next. And I will see you next time. Bye.
If you ask yourself, is it just me? Is it just me? Is this so good? I- I shouldn't have to be afraid. Is it just me? Yeah, is it just me? Is this so, so good? I shouldn't have to be for free. I know you working day and night to get a college degree. Ain't nobody that you